Stand your ground, men! Don't fire! Unless fired upon! But if they mean to have a war, let it begin here!
Pitcairn.
Disperse, you damn rebels! Lay down your arms and disperse!
What the deuce are you doing? Hold your position! Cravens! Traitors!
They are not coming back. You will have to make do with those who remain.
Don't you lecture me, Orna. Return fire! Return fire! You need to get to Concord and warn the others. Show this to whoever leads there. Should be a man by the name of James Barrett. Go on now!
Come on! We'll meet up with the others in Concord!
Get moving, men! We've little time! And keep the pace! To Concord, lads!
Help! What's happening?
Get out! Everyone, run! They're taking prisoners! Run!
Redcoats are taking captives!
We have to help!
I've got a surprise for those lobster banks!
Blood's been spilled in Lexington, and there's more to come. The regulars are on the march.
You don't say. And why do you think I'm met up here? Go home, or you get yourself killed. I've enough to worry about without some green boy looking to play at hero.
I can vouch for him.
John Parker as well. Where's Revere?
Captured.
What?
Fear not. That man's no stranger to sticky situations. He'll be fine. I'm sure of it.
Your ladies finished gossiping? Parker seems to believe you're not completely useless, so I suppose there's a thing or two you might be able to help with. When the fighting starts, we'll need to hold those positions there. They're critical to the defense of Concord. Good boys. Not used to soldier, and they need some with the experience to direct them. That's something you can do. You'd best be telling the truth.
You have my word.
Then I suppose all that's left to do is wait.
Sir! Man the barricades!
No! Ensure my men hold those positions. If the Red Devils break through, we're finished.
What would you have me do?
Listen carefully. The Redcoats will form firing lines. Order the men to shoot just before the line is ready. Too soon and they'll miss their targets. Too late, and the enemy will open fire first.
Understood.
And if any of those bastards make it through, engage them. You must keep my men alive.
Wait for my signal.
Wait
Open fire. Go! Wait for my signal. Wait for my signal. Shoot! Prepare yourselves. Open fire. Signal. Fire now. Hold fire. Go. Hold fire. Fire now. Wait for my signal. Shoot. Wait for my signal. Go! Wait for the signal. Wait for the signal. Shoot! Wait for my signal. Prepare yourselves. Go! Prepare yourselves. Wait for my signal. Open fire. Hold fire. Prepare yourselves. Shoot. Prepare yourselves. Shoot. Wait for my open fire. Hold fire! Go! Prepare yourselves. Fire now! Wait for my signal. Fire now! Wait for my signal. Wait for the signal. Shoot! Hold fire! Shoot! Wait for the signal. Fire! Wait for the signal. Go! Wait for the signal. Go! Prepare yourselves. Make ready. Fire now. Wait for the signal. Hold fire. Shoot. Prepare yourselves. Make ready. Go.
tell.
Shoot!
Prepare yourself. Open fire. Hold fire! Fire! Prepare yourselves. Open fire. Hold fire!
Go! Go!
Wait for the signal. Wait for my signal.
Fire now! Fire now!
Prepare yourself!
Go!
Fall back! Fall back!
We did it! They're turning tail!
Takes a true monster to do something like this. At least they're gone.
I should have struck when I had the chance. Do you know where Pitcairn could have gone?
Back into the withered bosom of the British, no doubt. So that he may regroup and plan his next atrocity.
I need to find him. Every day I wait, more will suffer.
Chin up, friend. Many who should have died today now live because of you.
And what of them?
We do the best we can with what we've got.
It is not enough.
It never is.
For the support of the glorious cause. I beg they will accept my most cordial thanks for this distinguished testimony of their approbation. But lest some unlucky event should happen, unfavorable to my reputation, I beg it may be remembered by every gentleman in the room that I, this day, declare with utmost sincerity, I do not think myself equal to the command I am honored with.
Truly, there is no man better suited to the task.
Sir, I beg leave to assure the Congress that as no pecuniary consideration could have tempted me to have accepted this arduous employment at the expense of my domestic ease.
I would not expect you to remember.
Come, Connor, there's someone I want you to meet.
I will keep an exact account of my expenses.
Sorry to pull you away like that.
I doubt not they will discharge.
The last thing we need is the two of you coming to blows. Now, Connor, allow me to introduce you to our newly appointed Commander-in-Chief, George Washington.
Ah, so you're the one who saved Sam and John at Lexington.
It was the Patriots who did that. I merely lent support.
As humble as he is brave, we could use more men like you. I'm sorry, but if you'll excuse me, I should attend to Charles over there. He looks none too happy about being passed over for command. It was good to meet you, Connor.
Tell me you have news of Pitcairn.
I'm told he's taken shelter in Boston, where he's guarded by 1,000 redcoats. The only way you're gonna get at him is if we draw him out. Now, lucky for you, we're launching an offensive against the city in order to do just that. Israel Putnam has been given command of our forces. Present this to him, and he'll provide whatever aid you require. You'll find him at the encampment on Bunker Hill.
You have my thanks.
No need. It's the least I could do. Pitcairn's a dangerous man. The sooner we're rid of him, the better.
I would say the same of Charles Lee.
Now that's an altogether different beast. Let us leave it for another day. Best you head to Boston, Connor. Still here, are you?
I was just wondering.
You've been warned! You asked for it!
What happened?
They demanded we give our entire yield to the crown. Warren refused. They killed our animals, salted our earth, then dragged us out. You saw what followed. I'm afraid we have nothing to give you in thanks, stranger. We have nothing left.
Perhaps there is something you could do instead.
Anything.
I live in a small community not far from here. The soil is rich. The people I live with would have need of fresh vegetables, wheat, or corn. If you were to rebuild your farm, you may prosper.
What kindness is this? You'll certainly come see. Thank you.
Thank you. Here for a You want a chance? You gotta hit me! Won't get far hitting me like that! Chance? You gotta hit me! Won't get far hitting me like that! Don't get far hitting me like that. Right on my arse!
Look like a man up for a challenge. There's a bobcat round these parts, wily as they come. I've lost count of them who tried to get him on account of his pelt. Pretty near perfect. You got that? You'd make a mint, not to mention something of a reputation.
What's your pleasure today? Hold and stay your...
I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
Follow me.
It's not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Breed's. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Redcoats rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough. Putnam's just up ahead. You calm it.
I don't care much for your excuses, gentlemen. We should be building on Bunker Hill.
Breed's is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their...
I rest my case. I'm going back to Bunker Hill. Good day, gentlemen.
General Putnam.
What?
I'm looking for someone. I was told you'd be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside that city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Well, then what? I'd be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
You supply the flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral.
Thank you.
Better numbers, he says. Better weapons, better training.
But I do not fear. And neither should you. For what they have in material, they lack in conviction and care. But not us. We have discipline. We have order. And most importantly, we have passion.
We believe! So maintain vigilance. Conserve your ammo. Ensure a proper line of sight. And above all else, men, do not fire until you see the whites of their eyes. I'll be damned. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston. As I said, he would. And set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom growing down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit and wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you propose the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because your man's a march hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Thank you. Why? Why did you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss. To explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do not think we ask the same question of the British. These things take time. And I would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
For better we hold the strings than another.
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Saha yunere ne o te nam da set takwe. Tini o ne yaho te na tam da set takwe.
Speak up on me like that! Why don't you just go off there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean? This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
My enemy is tenacious. When money failed them, they took to force. But I have slain Johnson and Pitcairn both, ending their plots. George Washington now rallies the colonists, and their march towards freedom begins in earnest. Little wonder, then, that the Templars now want him dead. They seek to reshape this land into something cold and ordered, something soulless. And he is an obstacle. I must save him, that his cause can flourish and my people remain safe. But the more I prod, the greater the chance I am discovered. The Templars believe their men lost the revolution. In their eyes, the assassins are gone and scattered, no longer a threat. But I fear they will soon discover the truth, and me along with it. I must tread carefully.
How fares the hunt, Connor?
There is progress, but I worry it is not enough.
You must strike where you need it most. What if you pursued Charles Lee and your father? What then of Paul Revere and the soldiers at Lexington?
Soldiers? There were no soldiers in those towns, only men and women who were forced to defend themselves.
Is this not why you fight? To protect your people? Your struggle is the colonists' struggle. In helping one, you help the other.
Encouraging words from one who thought mine a fool's errand.
Make no mistake. I still do. But I can't help but feel some pride in your success.
And why should I give you any credit?
Then don't. But first, return the robe and the blade and the darts and all of the years of training and knowledge I have bestowed upon you. Return these, and then your words may have some merit.
Or you could just admit that you are wrong.
Oh, child, please, you've killed two men. One more salesman than soldier. You're gonna have to try a lot harder than that to impress me.
Is that so, old man? Or perhaps we should step outside. I will gladly demonstrate how easily I could trounce.
Connor, this is Benjamin Talmadge. His father was one of us, no need for secrecy. I think he has something he wants to say.
Achilles tells me you've uncovered a plot to murder the Commander-in-Chief.
Yes, but I have only false starts and dead ends to show for it.
Not anymore, my friend. Thomas Hickey's your man, and I aim to help you catch him.
How?
I'll explain on the way. You and I are going to New York.
Thank God you are here. Prudence is missing. She went out to gather some things this morning and never returned. I'm worried sick. What if she's hurt?
I will find her.
The dog might help track her down. He has a good nose. Come on, boy! He has been gathering the evening primrose almost every night. She is obsessed with the oil it yields. That is all going to stop now. I don't understand why she wants so damn much of the stuff. She picked some here. She can't be far. We should split up to cover more ground. Prudence! Where are you? Connor, anything yet?
Thank you so much, Connor. Thank you. I don't want to think what might have happened if you had not arrived. I saw some primrose growing there, and the bear just came charging at me.
Why are you gathering primrose?
Well, Warren and I have been trying to conceive a child for a long time now. I read that evening...
Prudence! Are you all right, my love?
I'll be fine. Thanks to Connor.
Thank you, Connor. Once again.
Stop!
Where's the trouble, Connor? So you'd hear past chasing a man.
He was trying to rob your home. It has been dealt with.
What? Oh, the women. Is everyone all right?
You should have been there.
What?
I told you to head back. I didn't I need you?
Since when is a skinny runt like you safe out in the bush alone?
If Diana's hurt, I swear you'll be the one. I'm gonna smash you, you looby! I'm gonna smash you, you looby! Time I set you straight!
I'm gonna beat you senseless!
I'm gonna smash you, you looby! Time I set you straight!
You need some sense knocked into you! I'm gonna beat you senseless!
I'm gonna smash you, you looby!
You need some sense knocked into you! You need some sense knocked into you!
Time I set you straight.
Come on, scapegrace.
Time I set you.
You all right? There's no need for this.
Yeah, he's a blockhead.
He'll kill off in a spell. Just needs some time is all.
Not angry, Godfrey?
Me? Not at all. Terry's just got himself a temper, and I won't let him get away with it. It's really no trouble. He'll calm down. The runt couldn't do much damage anyway.
Does this happen often?
Ha! I was just telling Lance how I can set that calendar by these events. It's really not a worry, Connor. But I appreciate your concern.
So what is your stake in all this?
Same as yours. Peace, stability. A land in which all might live side by side, free and equal.
Why not join the Brotherhood, then?
My father was an assassin. Quite good at his job, too, as I understand it. But I hope to have children someday. It's hard to live in two worlds at the same time. So I chose to live in one.
I understand.
I still contribute as I can. That's why we're here now.
What can you tell me of Thomas Hickey?
He has been running a counterfeiting ring in the city. Locate the source of his operation, and we can have him arrested. He cannot harm the commander if he is in prison.
Do you know where he is?
Not exactly, but I have an idea where we can begin the search. Of bad bills being circulated here. No doubt they come from Thomas.
What are you up to? This isn't money. It's colored paper. You've cheated me for the last time. Guards!
Daniel, let's put them bills away. The guards is onto us.
How?
What happened?
The damn shopkeep called me out. Oh, God. I gave him a slip.
What?
Everyone in the shop.
What's this? Thomas Hickey? Might be. What's it to you? Oh, ain't supposed to be none of your kind left. Suppose I'd best be rectifying that then. Get him!
Hands off, I seen it first. Any close and I'll cut you.
Be still. You will do no more harm.
You're a right fool meddling in affairs you know nothing about.
Washington's the only thing keeping the Continental Army together. You kill him, you end all hope for freedom.
Wrong, boyo. With him gone, they'll have no choice but to promote Lee, and then...
You are both under arrest!
Oh, well, we were just having a scrap, officer. Ain't nothing wrong with two men settling their differences the old-fashioned way. Can't we come to a...
Quiet!
What are the charges?
Counterfeiting!
I had nothing to do with that.
Course not!
Listen, there are more important things at stake here. This man is planning to...
You miss me, sweetheart. What? Nothing to say?
If you are here, then Washington is safe.
True, true. Thing is, I believe I've just been pardoned. Thank you kindly for the rescue, gents.
There can be no further mistakes, Thomas. Am I understood?
What about the assassin? Yeah, he's here. They put him in a cell right next to mine. Guess we didn't get them all, eh?
Deal with this, Charles.
At once, sir.
What are we gonna do?
You're that boy from the Continental Congress. Adams's little lapdog. I think I have an idea. Yes. Two birds with one stone.
Do tell.
All in good time. It's not like the assassin's going anywhere. For now, we should see about getting you better accommodations here.
What are you on about? I thought I was getting out.
I'm afraid you won't be leaving for a while, thanks to Benjamin Talmadge. He's been running his mouth, saying all sorts of things. You're being investigated for plotting to assassinate George Washington.
What a bunch of bollocks. I thought you was gonna handle that.
We'll discuss this elsewhere.
Planning an escape. We should get in on it.
Yeah? And what makes you think that?
Caught him carving something in the yard. Slipped it in his pocket real quick when he saw me. Looked like a key.
Probably just a shiv.
Nah. Mason ain't a fighter. Always talking and tricking his way out of trouble. Weasel Weems, they call him. Stinky bastard.
Come on, Finch. He's not so bad. Even taught me some letters once. Gonna write a note to my lady.
Ha! What for? You think that whore's out there pining for you? Saving herself for when you get out? Huh? No doubt she's already moved on to the next fella, and the fella after him.
You shut your mouth before I shut it for you.
Easy now. It was just a joke.
Yeah? Well, it wasn't very funny.
Smells even worse than it looks.
Get up!
Where are we going?
Stay out of trouble or you'll wind up in the pit.
What are
are you looking at, half-breed? You not understand English, that it? Do I need to knock some sense into that thick head of yours?
I should try and find this Weems fellow. If he intends to escape, perhaps he can help me. Mason Weems?
Could be.
I need your help.
Oh?
They say you know a way out of here.
They say a lot of things.
I do not have time for games.
Shame. As I was hoping you might play one with me.
Fine.
Are you familiar with the rules? Seeing as you already know mine, what's your name?
Connor.
Pleased to meet you, Connor. Well played. So, what brings you to Bridewell?
Treachery. I have been falsely accused.
Of course you have.
You do not believe me?
Why should I? You have the look of a brute.
You misjudge. I am an honest man.
And yet, also a man imprisoned. Tell me how you found yourself in this place.
It is a private matter.
As is what you ask of me.
I was trying to prevent a murder.
Oh. Anyone I know?
George Washington.
The others put you up to this, didn't they? Thought it might be fun to have another laugh at Mason's expense. Fools, a lot of them. To make light of something like this? George Washington is brave beyond measure. Loyal like a brother, peerless in character, and unshakable in his convictions. That man is our Jupiter Conservator. Destined to lead us not just to freedom, but greatness. Anyone who says otherwise is either a simpleton or a traitor.
Then you understand why I need to get out of here. If I don't help him, he is going to die.
You're serious, aren't you? Very well. It's going to take some doing. See, everything hinges on the key I forged. But that lout Finch stole it. Took me 3 months to make the thing, too. You need to get it back, or we're not going anywhere.
Consider it done.
Thank you.
This key is useless.
What are you looking at? You in the market for Osbin?
Your key is useless.
What do you mean?
It did not fit the lock.
It's not meant to.
You forged a key that does not work.
Well, that all depends on what you mean by work. It'll get us out of here. Just not the way you expected.
Then how?
You're going to use it to get the real key off the warden. You have to swap yours for his.
Why not just have me take the real key? Why all this extra work?
He might notice if it went missing. This way, he'll be none the wiser.
And when he tries to use it?
He won't. That's why we're targeting him.
How do I reach the warden?
Yes. This next part, you may not like.
Oh, as if I've liked the others. Out with it.
You need to pick a fight.
What?
Pick a fight, and they'll throw you in the pit.
And how in the world does this help us?
The warden oversees the pit. Getting sent there is the only way to reach him.
I give you credit. You've given this plan to risk my life a great deal of thought.
Take down as many as you can. One or two will only serve to entertain the guards. You need to make them angry. We all have our part to play. Try not to die.
Fancy yourself a troublemaker, eh? Some time in the pit should cool your blood.
Look at all of you, pathetic, dirty wretches. You're not but swine, suckling at the teats of civilization. Thieves and scoundrels all. And do you acknowledge this? Do you rip...
need to take care not to raise the alarm.
Hey, hold a moment, Squire. Get back here, you jackass. No, you don't.
I'll piss on it. Let's get back.
You'll find Hickey through that door. It's where they keep the important prisoners. Nicer rooms, more space, those sorts of things. It seems even in prison, who you know makes all the difference.
Thank you, Mason, for everything. I will find a way to repay the favor when my work here is finished.
Not who you was expecting, am I right?
What have we here? I thought we'd finished off your kind.
You would like that, wouldn't you? To rid the world of all who do not share your views.
Guilty as charged. Your meddling in the revolution has caused us no small measure of grief. It cannot continue. Our work is too important. But what would you know beyond all the lies Achilles feeds you and the tales you tell yourself?
I know that the people wish to be free, and that men like Washington fight to make it so.
Please, the man is weak. He stumbles and stammers through each engagement, making it all up as he goes along. His pedigree is pathetic, his military record even more so. I could go on and on, but we'd be here for days. So manifold are his faults, so deficient are his merits. He must be dealt with. You as well. I will abide no more flies in the ointment.
Here's how it's gonna work. First we bind you and bring you to your cell. Then tomorrow, you go before the court, accused of plotting to kill good old Georgie. Maybe we could pin the murder of the warden on you too. You did kill him after all. And who wouldn't take the word of Charlie over here? Once that's all squared away, well then.
All those years ago, the child in the forest was you.
I said I would find you.
And so you have.
But not quite as you had expected, am I right? You know, all of this might have been avoided had you only done what I asked. Ah, but what's done is done.
Hello, Connor. Didn't think I'd miss your going away party, did ya? I hear Washington himself is gonna be in attendance. Hope nothing bad happens to him.
You said there'd be a trial.
Oh, no trial for traitors, I'm afraid. Lee and Hafham sorted that. It's straight to the gallows for you.
I will not die today. The same cannot be said for you.
That's enough! Keep moving!
Then you need us.
Forget about me. You need to stop Hickey. He's...
Up you go. Don't want to be late now, do we?
You just had to be an hero, didn't you? You and Georgie both. Now you see what it gets you. A pine box and little else.
Brothers, sisters, fellow patriots. Several days ago, we learned of a scheme so vile, so dastardly, that even repeating it now disturbs my being. The man before you plotted to murder our much beloved general. Indeed, what darkness or madness moved him, none can say, and he himself offers no defense, shows no remorse. And though we have begged and pleaded with him to share what he knows, he maintains a deadly silence. If the man will not explain himself, if he will not confess and atone, what other option do we have but this? He sought to send us into the arms of the enemy. And thus we are compelled by justice to send him from this world. May God have mercy on yourself.
Need to stop, Hickey. Go!
Damn it. I thought I'd at least live to see another day. Shame.
I want answers. Why did Johnson try and buy my people's land? Why was Pitcairn targeting Adams and Hancock? What purpose would Washington's murder have served? Why does your order support the British?
How should I know? The Templars, Lee, the big man, Hafham. They has the money. They has the power. That's the reason I threw him with them. That's the only reason. Sure, they have some sort of vision for the future too. I didn't give a damn about any of that. They can sing their songs about mankind and its troubles. They can make their plans and spring their traps. Don't bother me none. They paid me, so I said yes. Didn't bother to ask who. Or how, or why. Didn't care.
You chose to side with men who would rob us of our humanity simply because it was more profitable?
What else is there? I'm not some blind fool to give up all I've got on principle. What is principle anyway? Can you bring it to the bank? Don't look at me like that. We're different, you and I. You're just some blind fool who's always chasing butterflies. Whereas I'm the type of guy who likes to have a beer in one hand and a tea in the other. Thing is, boy, I can have what I seek. Had it even. You, your hands will always be empty.
I said, lower your goddamn guns! This man's a hero!
Oh, the general can be so stubborn sometimes. Piffle, he said, when we warned him something like this would happen. Piffle!
Stop!
He wanted to kill the commander. Nearly killed you as well. He was a scoundrel.
But still a man.
You're nothing if not consistent.
Where is Washington? I need to speak with him.
Bundled off as soon as your execution went sideways. He's likely on his way back to Philadelphia by now.
And so am I.
Something wrong?
He is still in danger. Hickey did not act alone.
It's quite impressive what you've accomplished.
Is that a compliment?
Well, don't misconstrue. I'm sure the whole endeavor will end tragically. But to have come this far, well, it's more than I ever expected.
The people yearn for freedom but fear to grab hold of it. That fear is gone now.
Thanks to you?
No. This they did on their own.
You diminish your role. But you have always been of humble heart.
I do what is right. No more, no less.
You cannot tell him.
I have to. Otherwise, he will never be safe.
He is safer not knowing. By planting the seeds of doubt, you threaten to topple his entire endeavor. If Washington is paralyzed, Charles Lee will strike. You'll cause the very thing you aim to prevent. Hunt the Templars, as is your duty. But do not drag these men into it.
We must now all hang together.
Yes, we must indeed all hang together. Or most assuredly, we shall all hang separately.
You are once more our savior.
I must speak with the commander.
He's gone to try and hold New York. The British intend to take it. I fear we'll need to recall our men from Quebec as well. It's one thing to declare our independence. Now, my friend, we must make it so.
Everything all right?
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
Rebecca?
Bad reception. Can you hear me?
Well, glad to see that's working. Guess I'll try you back when I'm topside.
Pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Billiette?
Now to find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
Billiette, please.
Certo, pode entrar.
Por favor.